गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनम् श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ शन्नो मित्रश्यं वरुणः शन्नो भवत्वर्यमा शन्नैन्द्रो बृहस्पतिः शन्नो विष्णुरुरुक्रमः। नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायो त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु अवतु माम् अवतु वक्तारम्। ओम शांति शांति शांति। डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी वर रीडिंग दि सेकंड अनुवाक ऑफ भृगुवल्ली ऑफ तैत्तिरीयोपनिषत्। सेकंड अनुवाक दट इज अन्नम ब्रह्मेति व्यजाना। वी कंप्लीटेड द भाष्यम आल्सो। देर वी वर सीइंग how this Bhrugu, our student here, the Bhrugu is the student, his father Varuna is the teacher. So he approached his father, he gave him certain data. These are all the doors of perception. You deliberate, you think on these, you contemplate on these, you reflect on these, and then you will find the truth. So that is what he said. Of course, initially he did not say tapasa brahma vijignasasva, he did not say. He merely told, these are the things which, this is the laboratory which you have, these are the tools you have, this is the mind, these are the sense organs, etc. And then you think about that, yato va imani bhutani jayante, that which is the source for the origin of all the beings, sustenance of all beings, and that into which all these things resolve, that you find out as Brahma. And you try to find out with whatever equipment you have. So that is what he said. Then the son, he thought, okay, his father did not specifically talk about tapas. That is, tapas means contemplation or reflection as the best means, or rather the only means to find out the truth. So he realized that he has to do some tapas, and then that is contemplation or reflection on what his father has said. And then at the initial level, he realized that annam. Annam means not merely at the adhyatma level. Adhyatma level means at the body level, but at the cosmic level. At the cosmic level, that Virat is what is Brahma. So that is what he realized. And then, and also he got a doubt that, you see, his father has given a definition, and that definition has to lakshanam. In fact, I was telling you the meaning of lakshanam yesterday. Lakshanam is something which has to be properly and fully applicable to a thing. There should not be any over application and there should not be any under application. So that should be, the lakshanam is a property. Lakshyamatra vyapako dharmaha. So that is how these logicians, they do define. Lakshyamatra vyapaka. That has to apply to the lakshyam only, and it should not deviate. It should not, there should not be any vyabhicharitvam there. There should not be ativyapti or avyapti. So that is how he examined. So he realized that, okay, annam is Brahma, but annam is also karyam. Annam means that Virat. Virat is something which is a karyam. Karyam means something which has come into effect. So then again he went to father. Father, at this time he said, tapasa brahma vijignasasva. You know the Brahman through tapas. Then again sa tapas tattva. Then again he is coming back to the father. So here we read the bhashyam also. While reading the bhashyam, the last one or two words, while we were hastily concluding that last class, that one word was there, ruju anyat.
Yes.
So I said it is ruk, it is not ruk, ruju anyat. Ruju means, ruju is straight, ruju margam, ruju pravartana, ruju charitam. So like that, straight means clear. Ruju anyat means the rest of it is clear, rest of it we need not, Shankaracharya has not commented on the next three anuvakas. So that is why he says ruju anyat. So we were hastily concluding and we read it wrongly yesterday. So let us move to the next valli, that is Trutiyonuvaka. So from this Virat, we are moving on to Virat is the grass, the cosmic grass body, and then we are moving on to the cosmic subtle body, where you find, like in our body also, what in the subtle body? Subtle body consists of this prana and the indriyas, mind, intellect, all these things, they are there in the subtle body. So those, we are coming to that level of Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha at the level of Kriya Shakti, that is Hiranyagarbha at the level of prana, we see first. That is pranam brahmeti vyajanat. Then Hiranyagarbha at the level of mind, cosmic mind, we see. And then again Hiranyagarbha at the level of vijnanam. Of course, vijnanam level, it is also called mahat sometimes. But generally speaking, Hiranyagarbha is one name which is generally applied to all these three. You can call it either Mahat, Vijnana Brahma, or you can call it Hiranyagarbha. Of course, here, Anandagiri Tika, it does not make any distinction between Hiranyagarbha and Mahat. Anandagiri is saying, Vicharyacha tat karanam, Kriyashakti Vishishtataya Pranashabda Lakshyam Hiranyagarbham. Kriyashakti Vishishtataya Pranashabda Lakshyam Hiranyagarbham. Hiranyagarbha, who can be identified or who can be seen at the level of Kriyashakti. Kriyashakti is Prana Shabda Lakshyam. He is also called Prana. He is also called Sutratma. There is one more name which we have heard in some earlier context. At the Prana level, he is called Sutratma. Otherwise called Hiranyagarbha. So Hiranyagarbha is a general name which is applicable, which is applied to the cosmic mind, cosmic vital self, vital body, and cosmic vijnana, all those things. So he says, Kriyashakti at the level of Prana Brahma, it is Kriyashakti. Then again at the level of, say, Sankalpa, he continues, Hiranyagarbham, Sankalpadhyavasaya Shakti Vishishtatayacha, Mano Vijnana Shabdam Lakshyam Brahma, iti Vyajanat. Mano Vijnana Shabda Lakshyam Brahma. That is the same Hiranyagarbha Brahma at the level of mind and at the level of Vijnana. So we are going to see that. Let us read it, because there is no great, Shankaracharya has not written any commentary for all these three Anuvakas. For the last Anuvaka only, that is sixth Anuvaka, when it comes to Ananda. So there he talks about Ananda. So there he has given Sambhashyam. So we will just read it and I will very briefly talk about it. Prano brahmeti vyajanat. Pranadhye vakal vima nibhuta nijayante. Pranena jata nijivanti. Pranam prayantyabhi samvishanti iti. Tadvignaya punareva varunam pitaram upasasara adhihi bhagavo brahmeti tagum hovacha tapasa brahma vijignyasasva tapo brahmeti satapo tapyata satapastaptva iti trutiyonuvakaha. So here prano brahmeti vyajanat. So that gentleman Bhrugu, he is applying that definition to various levels. Like in Adhyatma, you see there are two levels here. One is the Adhyatma level and one is the Adhidaiva level. Adhyatma level, we are very clear about the gross body. We are clear about the vital self, that is the prana shakti. And then again, we also have an idea about this mind. We are having an idea about the vijnana. We are having an idea about this ananda. Ananda means this vishaya sambandha janita ananda. This vishaya ananda, as we see. When I get an object and I have ananda. So that is one level. Or at the level of sushupti also. So these five levels at the adhyatma. Adhyatma level means at the level of the body, at the level of the individual, at the level of vyashti, let us say. This we know. At the cosmic level also, we are seeing the Virat. We are seeing again Hiranyagarbha at three different levels. We are seeing that. So this he is applying this definition to the next level. So next level, prano brahmeti vyajanat. So he realized that prana is the thing. Because pranadhyeva kalvimani bhutani jayante. Because of this prana only, all these beings are coming into existence. By that, they are all living and into which they are all resolving back. So that is Brahma. Then again he got a doubt. Then again, Punareva Varunam Pitaram Upasasara, he went back to his father. And then father duly said, okay, tapasa brahma vijignyasasva, you do more contemplation, do more reflection. Tapo brahmeti, tapa itself is brahma. That is, tapa itself is brahma means it is so important. It is so important that you are not distinguishing tapas from brahma. So that is in order to extol, in order to praise that is the most effective sadhanam, the most effective means for knowing the truth. So that is what his father said. Then again he went and satapas tattva. Then what did he realize? Next we will come to mano brahmeti vyajanat. Let us read. मनो ब्रह्मेति व्यजानात् मनसोह्येव खल्विमानिभूतानि जायन्ते तद्विज्ञाय पुनरेव वरुणं पितरम् उपससार अधीहि भगवो ब्रह्मेति तगं होवाच तपसा ब्रह्मविजिज्ञासस्व तपो ब्रह्मेति स तपो तप्यत स तपस्तप्त्वा इति चतुर्थोऽनुवाकः. So he applied this thing to the mind, the cosmic mind level. So then again, mano brahmeti vyajanat. Oh, it is not enough if there is a body only, and it is not enough if it is having some energy. But there is a necessity for somebody who directs it. So the next level, that sankalpa vikalpatmakam manaha, that something which is, what is the use of a body? There is energy also, but the mind is not there. If the mind is absent, then what is the use of the body? So he realized that, okay, mind is something which is more subtle and more, at a higher level, let us say. So then he realized that mind is Brahma, because of that only everything is living, everything is surviving, and everything is getting back into that thing only. So that is what he realized. But then he again realized that cosmic mind also is something which is a karya. After all, that also is a karya. Mind also is a karya. So then he again went to the father. He again said, okay, you do tapas. Then again he did the tapas. And then again we have come to the Vijnanam Brahma level. Let us see the Vijnanam Brahma level. Vijnanam Brahmeti Vyajanat. विज्ञानाद्येव खल्विमानि भूतानि जायन्ते विज्ञानेन जातानि जीवन्ति विज्ञानं प्रयन्त्यभिसंविशन्ति इति तद्विज्ञाय पुनरेव वरुणं पितरमुपससार अधीहि भगवो ब्रह्मेति तगं होवाच तपसा ब्रह्मविजिज्ञासस्व तपो ब्रह्मेति स तपो तप्यत स तपस्तप्त्वा. So all these anuvakas are identical. If you have seen Annamaya Kosha, that is Annam Brahmeti Vyajanat, all the rest are, they are just same words, except for Annam you substitute prana, and again you substitute mana, you substitute vijnana. So now we have come to the level of vijnana. So there is one thing called grass body. And after grass body, we have seen Hiranyagarbha at the level of prana, what is called kriya shakti. Then again, we have seen the mind. Mind is sankalpa vikalpatmakam. It sees something, it registers something, and there is a desire. That is what is called icha shakti. Then we have now come to this vijnanam brahmeti vyajana, that is a jnana shakti level we have come. So we talk of three shaktis, icha shakti, jnana shakti, kriya shakti, swarupini we say. So that jnana shakti, we have come to that level. Vijnanam Brahma iti Vyajanat. And this Vijnanam is, you can call it Hiranyagarbha or you can call it Mahat, whatever you want. Of course, Anandagiri has not made any distinction. प्राणशब्द लक्ष्यम हिरण्यगर्भम दट इज नंबर वन देन संकल्प संकल्प अध्यवसाय शक्ति विशिष्टतया च मनो विज्ञान शब्द लक्ष्यम सो संकल्प एट द लेवल ऑफ संकल्प एंड एट द लेवल ऑफ अध्यवसाय अध्यवसाय मीन्स डिटर्मिनेशन अध्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धि दट इज विज्ञान सो एट दीज टू लेवल्स वी आर सीइंग द सेम ब्रह्म बिकॉज ब्रह्म इज समथिंग विच इज देर ब्रह्म चैतन्यम इज देर इन ऑल थिंग्स इट इज नॉट एज दो ब्रह्म इज नॉट देर इन अन्नमय कोश और अन्न स्थूल ग्रास से समष्टि स्थूल शरीर और विराट इट इज वेरी मच देर बट इट इज नॉट दट इट इज देर ओनली इट इज देर इन अन्नमय कोश इट इज ऑल्सो देर इन प्राणमय कोश सो दट इज वाई the definition is not fully applicable to annamaya kosha it is only partly applicable annamaya kosha no doubt is brahma but that is not the only brahma there is some, another higher level or more subtle level and we have come to pranamaya kosha there also brahma is there and then that is not the only thing there again you have to move on to a higher level called manas there again there is a limitation mind again is it is a limit there is a limitation No doubt Brahman is there, but the beyond that or more subtle than that is that Vijnanamaya Kosha. So we are now talking about Vijnanamaya Kosha. Vijnanam Brahmeti Vyajanad. And it is because of this Jnana Shakti and the Vijnana Shakti also we see the first notion of I in the Supreme Consciousness is what is that Maya Vachinna say Brahma. That Maya Vachinna Brahma is that first level. From that, the whatever this, if you look at it from the point of view of a jiva, it is Hiranyagarbha. If you look at it from the point of view of a god, of the god or creator, it is Ishvara. So that is what we see. So this also is karyam. It is not the moolakaranam. The ultimate moolakaranam is supreme consciousness, which has no vikara, which has no change in it. All this thing is because of this, the effect of what is called maya shakti maya vachinnam chaitanyam so that concept of maya we have to apply here also so this is the first notion of I in that consciousness so he realizes he thinks that vijnana is the ultimate cause then again he reflects on that and then he realizes that it is not the ultimate cause there is something beyond that now we are coming to this anando brahmeti vyajanat anando brahmeti vyajanat here one point we have to see is All these levels we have talked about the kosha. All these levels, annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, either at the adhyatma level or at the adhidaivika level. So at both levels. So this adhyatma, adhidaivika levels, this Vanamalakara writes, in a beautiful way. Okay, I will read later when I read the Bhashyam. So he writes that, At the level of, say, Adhyatma, and also at the Adhyatma means at the individual Vyashti level, and at the level of Samashti, these five koshas he has been rejecting one after the other. But when it comes to Ananda, the text is not talking about the Anandamaya kosha. It is talking straight away talking about Brahma only. Ananda, which is the nature of Brahma, or Brahma, which is of the nature of Ananda, in a way you take. So, it's better to say the latter, Brahman, which is of the nature of Ananda. That is a better way. So, it is talking about that Brahma, which is of the nature of Ananda. So, not about Anandamaya Kosha, because beyond this, there is no further text. So, here, in whatever is described here, is about the Brahman only, and not about Anandamaya Kosha. Because the difference we know, the difference between Anandamaya Kosha and the Supreme Ananda. What is the difference? Anandamaya Kosha is Vishaya Vishayi Sambandha Janita. Janitaha Ananda. That is something which is the outcome of the contact with an external object. I possess something and I am happy. So if I lose that thing, I am unhappy. So that Ananda is dependent, it is contingent on, it is something which is Sapekshikam. And then Satishayam. So and then this is something which is limited. This is Vishaya Ananda. Whereas Brahman as Ananda, that is something which is the nature of bliss, that is the very nature of bliss. So that is something different. And here, at the lower level, Anandamaya Kosha, there is what is called Jnata, Jnayam, Jnanam, etc. There is somebody who is seeing something, possessing something, and then enjoying something. But at the level of Supreme, Ananda, there is no question of Jnata, Jnaya, that difference is not there, that Triputi disappears. It is pure, Sat, Chit, infinity plus Ananda. So that is what we that is what we have to see. So let us read the say Anuvaka first.
Yes.
Anando Brahmeti Vyajanat.
Anando Brahmeti Vyajanat.
Ananda Dhye Vakalvima Nibhuta Nijayante.
Ananda Dhye Vakalvima Nibhuta Nijayante.
Anande Najata Nijivanti.
Anande Najata Nijivanti.
Anandam Prayantya Visam Vishantiti. सैषा भार्गवी वारुणी विद्या गवी वारुणी विद्या परमे व्यो मन प्रतिष्ठिता य एवं वेद प्रतितिष्ठति अन्नवानन्नादो भवति महान् भवति प्रजया पशुभिर्ब्रह्मवर्चसेन प्रजया पशुभिर्ब्रह्मवर्चसेन महान् कीर्त्या ओके सो आनन्दः ब्रह्म इति व्यजानात् सो ही रियलाइज्ड दैट आनन्द अल्टीमेटली दिस आनन्द इज द फाइनल थिंग विच इज सीन एट द लेवल ऑफ इंडिविजुअल आल्सो दिस आनंदमय कोश आर सुषुप्ति दैट इज द फाइनल लेवल वेयर देयर इज नो where there is no movement at all, where there is no further this jnata jneya bheda is not there in sushupti. Of course in vishayananda this jnata jneya bheda is there, but in sushupti it is not there. And at the level of this supreme ananda also, beyond that there is nothing. So that he realized as Brahma, and he applied the definition. He applied the same definition which his father has given to him. Anandadeva, because it is only from that ananda only that all these things are originating, and because of that ananda all the things are surviving, are living. And anandam prayanti abhisambhishanti, anandam prayanti abhisambhishanti iti. And then they again move towards this ananda and enter or resolve into ananda. Because whatever we do is impelled by the desire for happiness only, isn't it?
Yes.
Whatever we do, the very fact that you and I are sitting here, the very fact that we are reading some Taittiriya Upanishad, it is for ananda only. It is giving some ananda to me, it is giving some ananda to you. So it is only because of that we do any act. So this is Anandadhyeva Kalvimani Bhutani Jayante. Only because of that all these things are appearing. Then Saisha Bhargavi Varuni Vidya. Saisha is Sa Esha. That, this. Sa is that, Esha is this. Oh, that Saisha means whatever has been told by this Bhrugu is the same Varuni Vidya. Sa Esha. Whatever has been seen by that Bhrugu is this Varuni Vidya. What is this Bhargavi? Bhargavi means relating to Bhrugu. Relating to Bhrugu is Bhargava. Because it is Srilinga, it is Bhargavi Vidya. Bhargavi. Varuni. What is Varuni? Varunasya Patyam Varuni. Varuna, related to Varuna is Varuni. Varuni Vidya. Then Parame Vyoman Pratishthita. Parame Vyoman. It is settled or established in the Supreme Akasha. Supreme Akasha means that intellect cave, that Buddhi Guha. Our intellect, the intellect is compared to the cave. And in that intellect, it is very much there. This Ananda is not even anywhere else. It is there very much in, say, the Buddhi Guha or the intellect cave. Then, Pratishthita. Pratishthita means that is well settled, well established. Then, Evam Veda Pratitishthati. The one who knows like this. He also stays, he gets established in Ananda. He is also establishing, he settles in Ananda. He becomes Ananda Swarupa. He becomes Brahman itself. So that is what Shankaracharya is going to say. Then, Annavan Annado Bhavati. Annavan Bhavati, Annadaha Bhavati. Annavan means one who is having a lot of plenty. Annavan means not merely food, but plenty. Abundance of say all things. So, but a question arises. Okay, that Bhashyam also will discuss it. You see, when he realizes that supreme Brahman, what is the use of all these external things? That question also will arise. So the text is going, the Bhashyakara is going to say, okay, when you are achieving a higher thing, there are certain add-on advantages also. There are certain add-on advantages. When you are, say, realizing that Nirguna Tattvam, you will also get whatever Saguna Brahma Upasana phalam also. This Saguna, the fruit of Saguna Brahma Upasana also is given as some bonus to you, as some add-on to you. Suppose you buy something in the shop, some sort of gift also is there. So something like that. So in order to extol this Brahma Vidya, in order to praise this Brahma Vidya, this is told, that is what Bhashyakara is going to say. Ya evam veda pratitishthati, up to that point is quite good, quite reasonable. That is, with the person who realizes that Ananda Brahma, he also settles, he becomes one with that. So that is what is it. Then beyond that, this annavan annado bhavati, this is something like some small frames. So annavan bhavati, annado bhavati, annavan means one who has plenty of food. Food means need not necessarily be food, but various other things. Annadaha bhavati, one who enjoys that, one who eats that, one who becomes the enjoyer of all these things. Then mahan bhavati, he also becomes great, become great, famous. Mahan in what manner? Prajaya pasubhihi brahmavarchasena mahan kirtiyacha. That is, maha, prajaya. Praja means children. Children, praja. Praja is a child. Prajaya, that is big by children. Pasubhihi means a lot of cattle wealth. Because in those Vedic days, the main wealth was cattle health only. So, cattle wealth. So, that cattle wealth, pasubhihi. Then, brahmavarchasena. This brahmavarchas shabda also we have seen earlier. Brahmavarchas is a person who has attained that degree of self, control, not only self-control, this sadhana, who a person who is in this sadhana marga and who has achieved the chitta samadhana, the tranquility of mind, his activities, the body language changes, his attitude changes, and then his very demeanor changes. So that cool, calm demeanor, and then the tendency to love everyone, tendency to say be one with the universe itself. So that is something. These are all things which become manifest in a jnani. So that behavior is seen. It is seen in him, and that brings some sort of glow in him. So that sort of glow, by virtue of this enlightenment, is called brahmavarchas. A sort of glow doesn't mean physical light or anything like that. His very bodily movements change. And then his activities, they do reflect all that thing. And then whatever he speaks, it will be pure. It will be pure right from his heart. So like that, that is what is called brahmavarchas. Brahmavarchasena mahan kirtya. And also he shines by virtue of lot of kirti. Kirti means fame. He becomes very famous. So that is what is shashtonuvakaha. Let us read the bhashyam. एवं तपसा विशुद्धात्मा प्राणादिषु साकल्येन ब्रह्मलक्षणम् अपश्यन् शनैः शनैः अन्तरनुप्रविश्य अन्तरतमम् आनन्दं ब्रह्म विज्ञातवान् तपसैव साधनेन भृगुः तस्मात् ब्रह्म विजिज्ञासुना बाह्यांतःकरण समाधान लक्षणं परमं तपः साधनं अनुष्ठेयमिति प्रकरणार्थः ओके एवं इन दिस मैनर We have seen, in this manner means, how this he, as in a due manner, he approached his father, he requested his father. So all these things, by this contemplation, tapasa, by virtue, by means of tapas. You got it or not? Evam, in this manner, tapasa vishuddhātma. Vishuddhāntahkaranaha. Atma means, not the supreme atma. It is antahkarana. Atma means several things depending on the context, isn't it? Atmaiva hyatmano bandhu, atmaiva ripuratmanaha. So there atma means self. So here also the self. Vishuddhatma means a person who has become very clear in his self, in his antahkarana. That means, clear means what? Earlier he had lot many notions of duality. lot many perceptions of love, hate and so many things, because of the perception of duality, all those things, they come into the mind. Now all those things have gone back. Now he is capable of seeing kevalam Brahma in everything. So at that level. So, and whatever say contemplation he did, that contemplation is on the Mahavakyas, isn't it? Contemplation is on Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi, on those words. And then he has contemplated, say, with reference to whatever tools he has. By means of whatever tools he has contemplated, and he has realized that he is not different from that Supreme Brahma. So that level of realization, that is something which is a clear antahkarana, shuddha antahkarana, vishuddhatma. Then pranadishu sakalyena brahma lakshanam apashyan. Brahma lakshanam means the definition of Brahma. Pranadishu brahma lakshanam apashyan. In this pranamaya kosha, in this annamaya kosha, in this vijnanamaya kosha, and in this manomaya kosha, he did not see this brahma lakshanam sakalyena. Sakalyena means completely. Sakala, you know the word sakala. Sakala means the whole. Sakalasya bhavaha sakalyam. Sakalasya bhavaha sakalyam. Sakalyena. Completely. It is partly applicable, no doubt. As I said, annamaya kosha also is Brahma. Pranamaya kosha also is Brahma. But that is not the only Brahma. Brahma is much beyond. Brahma is a greater vyapakam, isn't it? So, annamaya kosha is Brahma, pranamaya kosha is Brahma, manomaya kosha also is Brahma. But then that is not the only Brahma. Brahman is beyond it. So that is why sakalyena brahma lakshanam apashyan. So this brahma lakshanam did not fit into these things exactly. It is a loose garment, something like a loose garment. Somebody like some fellow who is like a thin fellow like me, he wore it first. He is gone. Then again a stouter fellow wore it. That all for him also it is too loose. Another stouter fellow wore it. So for him also it is loose. So like that all these levels are gone and finally you got somebody who fits into that size. So that is it. Sakalyena brahma lakshanam apashyan. It does not fit completely. Something like a loose garment into which several people they try and they get discarded. And finally you get a person who fits into that. Brahma lakshanam apashyan. Apashyan means not seeing it. Apashyan, not seeing it. Then, not past tense, it is not past tense. Apashyan is not past tense. Brahma lakshanam apashyan, kurvan, shrunvan, khadan, so like that. Shatrupratyaya. Apashyan. Then, shanaishyanaihi. Slowly and slowly. Because this process also, something it is something, it has to go on slowly. This Brahma vichara is something which also go, which has to go in a slow and steady manner. Straight away a fellow cannot accept, say, if it is said tattvamasi, straight away a man cannot accept. Aham Brahmasmi, straight away nobody can accept. You and I also, we are not able to accept, even after so many years of Vedanta Shravana. So, the moment we go out, we are in the world of duality. So, that is the problem. So, shanaishyanaihi antaha anupravishya. He entered inside. The literal meaning is antaha anupravishya, that is antar anupravishya, having gone deeper, having entered inside means having gone deeper, anupravishya, antar anupravishya, antaratamam anandam brahma vijnatavan. He realized that anandam brahma, that antaratamam, which is the innermost of all, the most subtle, beyond which there is nothing. So this application of what is this definition has to be perfect. Beyond that, it should not be anything. So, when there is said, this is the ultimate cause. Yato va imani bhutani jayante, yena bhajatani jivanti. That is the ultimate cause. So, annam is not the ultimate cause. Similarly, all other things are not the ultimate cause. The ultimate cause is that antaratamam, the innermost of all, is that anandam brahma. That is how he realized. Vijnatavan. Tapasaiva sadhanena bhruguhu. And what is this sadhanam? Tapasa eva. Tapasaiva. Sadhanena, by this tapasaya, by this tapas, by this contemplation or reflection, he realized it. Then, therefore, tasmat, therefore, brahma vijignyasuna, by someone who wants to seek Brahman, by someone, jignyasa, whoever is having the jignyasa, jnatumicha, whoever wants to pursue the knowledge of Brahman, for him, what is the utmost, what is the greatest sadhana? The greatest sadhana is tapas. Vijignyasuna, bahyantahkarana samadhana lakshanam paramam tapah. दिस सुप्रीम तपस् व्हाट इज दिस बाह्य अंतःकरण समाधान लक्षणम दिस नंबर वन सेल्फ कंट्रोल नंबर टू विचार बोथ आर इंक्लूडेड हियर समाधान चित्त समाधान नॉट मेयरली समथिंग लाइक समाधि ऑफ पतंजलि योग Samadhi of Patanjali Yoga, there is no vichara. The basic difference between Patanjali Samadhi and our Samadhanam is, in Patanjali Yoga, it is mere Chitta Samadhi, which is brought about as a sort of physical exercise. Abhyasa. Abhyasa Vairagya Abhyan Tannirodha, isn't it? So by physical Abhyasa and by some little bit of Vairagya and all that, a particular Samadhi state is attained. But there, this Chintana, Brahma Chintana is not there. So when Brahmachintana is also there, then there is a higher level of Chitta Samadhana. A person who is in Patanjali Yoga, Yoga Samadhi, once he comes out, that Samadhi Nishtha is gone. Again in the world of, he is in the world of duality. But this man, a Jnani, who has attained this Chitta Samadhanam, he is in the wakeful state or when he is eating, Pashyan, Shrunvan, Spruchan, Jighran, Ashdan, Gachan, whatever he is doing, he is in the state of samadhi. Yatra yatra manoyati tatra tatra samadhayah, that is what Panchadashikara says. Wherever the mind is, there you are in a samadhi. So that is what he says. So you are always aware. You are always aware that you are a sakshi. You are not this. You are always aware. Whatever you are doing, you are always aware that you are above all this and then your real self is something different. So samadhana lakshanam paramam tapaha. Sadhanam anushteyam. This is something which has to be followed. Anushteyam. Anushthana means something to perform something. Anushteyam means this is something to be performed. Tapas is something to be necessarily performed. Iti prakaranarthaha. The context, the meaning of this whole passage is that. Then adhuna akhyayikato apasrutya.
Adhuna akhyayikancha upasamrutya.
आख्यायिकां उपसंहृत्य देयर दैट इज उपसंहार यू सी उपसंहार मीन्स कंक्लूजन उपक्रम उपसंहार उपक्रम इज बिगिनिंग एंड उपसंहार इज कंक्लूजन आख्यायिकां उपसंहृत्य मीन्स हैविंग कंक्लूडेड द आख्यायिक हैविंग कंक्लूडेड दैट आल्सो इज करेक्ट हैविंग कंक्लूडेड द आख्यायिक दिस बुक सेज आख्यायिका तो अपसृत्य आख्यायिका तह दट इज पंचमी विभक्ति अपसृत्य हैविंग मूव्ड अवे अपसरति अपसरति अनुसरति अनुसरति अनुसृत्य अपसरति अपसृत्य दट इज ल्यप प्रत्यय यू नो दट आख्यायिका तह अपसृत्य दट इज हैविंग डीविएटेड नॉट डीविएटेड हैविंग मूव्ड अवे फ्रॉम दिस आख्यायिका इट मीन्स वन एंड द सेम आख्यायिका तो अपसृत्य श्रुति ही स्वेन वचनेन आख्यायिका निर्वृत्तमर्थम आचष्टे निर्वर्त्यम ओके दैट आल्सो इज ओके निर्वृत्तम निर्वर्त्यम निर्वृत्तम सीम्स टू बी बेटर निर्वृत्तमर्थम आचष्टे सैषा भार्गवी भृगुणा विदिता वरुणेन प्रोक्ता वारुणी विद्या व्योमन परमे व्योमन हृदयाकाश गुहायां परम आनंदे अद्वैते प्रतिष्ठिता ओके सो अधुना नाउ द टेक्स्ट इज मूविंग अवे फ्रॉम आख्यायिका सो देयर व्हाट इज इट The entire thing is, it is starting with Anando, Brahmaiti, Vyajanath and all those things, it is okay. Then it says, Saisha, Bhargavi, Varuni, Vidya. From there we are seeing. So, Akhyayikataha Apasrutya, having moved away from this Akhyayika. Shrutihi, this scripture, Svena Vachanena, means in its own words, Akhyayika Nirvruttam Artham Achaste. This Shruti is telling about the message of the whole Akhyayika. In its own words, the Shruti is telling about the message which has been derived. Nirvruttam. Nirvruttam means that which has been derived. That which has been extracted from this. Nirvruttam. Derived may be better. Nirvruttam artham achashte. The text is saying the overall meaning or overall purport of the purport which has been derived, which we can derive from this whole passage. What is that? Saisha, this is Sa Esha, this is the thing. Bhargavi means Bhruguna Vidita, that which is known by Bhrugu. Varunena Prokta, Varuni Vidya, this is something which is Varuni Vidya. Then Paramaya Vyoman, this Paramakasha, that Paramakasha is that Buddhi Guha, Hrudaya Guhayam, Hrudaya Akasha Guhayam, in that Buddhi Guha, that supreme space called intellect space and Guha. Then Parama Anande Advaite Pratishthita. So that means, the person, the seeker is somebody who is well settled in that supreme ananda, parama ananda, that advaita, that non-dual ananda, he is pratishthita. This vidya is something which is established there. Paramananda, paramanande advaite pratishthita. This where, what is pratishthita? This vidya. Vidya is pratishthita. It is well established there. Then parisamapta annamayat atmano adhipravrutta.
Adhipravrutta.
Okay, parisamapta annamayadatmanah adhipravrutta. Annamayadatmanah means starting from this annamayatma. Adhipravrutta. Adhipravrutta means that which has commenced from, that which has started from. Adhipravrutta vidya. Annamaya kutaha adhipravrutta. Annamayadatmanah adhipravrutta. It has started from, the starting point is annamaya kosha. From that starting point, whatever has come, now all that thing is now parisamapta. This parisama, this thing is, it is concluded here. Then, ya evam anyopi,
tapasaiva sadhanena,
anenaiva krameena anupravishya,
anandam brahma veda,
sa evam vidya pratisthanat, pratitishthati,
anande parame brahmani,
brahmaiva bhavati ityartha. Okay, ya eva manyopi. Okay, Bhrugu is one model before you. And you can also follow that Bhrugu. Ya evam, whoever in this manner. Yaha evam, who means whoever in this manner. Anyopi, anyaha, somebody else. Anyopi, even someone else in this manner. Tapasa eva sadhanena. By doing the same similar contemplation, by doing, following that, step-by-step approach, then anenaiva krameena, in the same manner, you have to discard the lower self and move on to a higher self. You have to discard the lower kosha and move on to, discard means discard identification. Atma bhava, you should not stop there only. You should not think that is the only thing. And that is what we do at the level of religion. At the level of religion, we identify something as God, and then okay, we are there only, and we get stuck there. And that is why Keno Upanishad says, Nedam yadedam upasate, what you worship is not the ultimate. It does not say, what you worship is not God. It only says, Nedam yadedam upasate, it only means, it does not mean what you worship is not true. What you worship is only limited. There is something beyond. You go to that beyond. So that is it. Anenaiva krameena anupravishya. Having gone deeper, anandam brahma veda. Whoever realizes this anandam brahma, sa evam vidya pratisthanat. By getting established in such knowledge, vidya pratisthanat means vidyayam pratisthanat. By virtue of having clarity in this type of awareness, then pratitishthati, he also gets established in what? Anande parame brahman. By virtue of this vidya, once you are clear about this vidya, you are clearly settled in paramananda, that supreme ananda. Then what is it? Brahmaiva bhavati. You see, anande parame brahmani pratitishthati, it can give one meaning. There is something called paramananda. This man goes and then he is entering into that. That means there are two things. Paramananda is one bag and then somebody else is going and then gets established. It's not like that. Brahmaiva bhavati. He becomes that. Paramati pratitishtati anande parame brahmani. It is in Saptami Vibhakti, isn't it? Saptami Vibhakti is adharo adhikaranam, isn't it? That is, Brahma is not some sort of box into which this man goes and enters. He becomes that. So that is what it is. I'll just read out one line from Anandagiri also. Anandagiri writes about what is this Ananda Brahma, what is this Prana Brahma, etc. वशिष्ठपरिषद विशुद्धानंद ब्रह्म इन द बिगिनिंग सेइंग दट आनंद ब्रह्म दिस पर्टिकुलर अनुवाक इज नॉट अबाउट आनंदमय कोश बट अबाउट ब्रह्म सो दट इज वाट आनंदगिरी अकॉर्डिंग टू आनंदगिरी ओनली यू सी ऑफ दिस विज्ञानम ब्रह्म आल्सो विज्ञानम ब्रह्म मनोब्रह्म ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर कार्य दे आर एट द लेवल ऑफ एफेक्ट ओनली दे आर नॉट द कारण सो तस्यापि कार्यत्वात् लक्षणं परिपूर्णं न भवति दिस लक्षणं और डेफिनेशन इज नॉट परफेक्टली फिटिंग इनटू दैट इति विचार्य हैविंग थॉट लाइक दैट तत् कारणं स्वातंत्र्येण निश्चित्य एंड स्वातंत्र्येण निश्चित्य एंड व्हाट इज द काज व्हाट इज द फाइनल काज सो ही डिड ही कंटेंप्लेटेड फर्दर ऑन दैट देन सर्वैः प्रार्थ्यमानतया आनंद शब्दवाच्यं माया विशिष्टं ब्रह्मेति विज्ञाय What is it that we all seek? Sarvaihi prarthyamanam. By all of us, what is it that is sought? Dvanandam Brahma. What is that Anandam Brahma? We are not talking about, we are not bothered about the Supreme Brahma, but we are bothered about some Maya Visishtam Brahma who will give us some bits and pieces of chocolates. So that is what we are worried. So, Ananda Shabdavachyam Maya Visishtam Brahma. Iti Vignaya. Okay, this Maya Visishtam Brahma is the final thing for all these things. That is in reality also, because Supreme Brahma is not the direct cause for creation and all. This Maya Visishtam Brahma, this Ananda Shabdavachyam again, it is also called Ananda. So that particular Brahma, that is the cause for all these things, iti Vignaya. Then he also thought, but Ananda Maya Visishtam Chaitanyam Brahma alone is not the Supreme. That also is, for that behind that there is a Supreme cause, that is what he says. माया विशिष्टं ब्रह्मेति विज्ञाय विशिष्टस्य विशिष्टांतर आत्मा आत्मत्वानुपपत्तेः कारणत्वोपलक्षितं विशुद्धानंदं ब्रह्म इति विज्ञातवान् दट कारणम द कारणम इज दट विशुद्ध आनंद कारणम इज दट विशुद्ध आनंद द प्योर आनंद वेर देर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो डिस्टर्बेंस ऑफ यू एंड आई एटसेट्रा सो दट इज द कारणम दट इज द अल्टीमेट कारणम दट इज वॉट ही हैज रियलाइज सो दट इज वाई As Anandagiri says, this particular Anuvaka is about not about Anandamaya Kosha. It is about the Supreme Ananda, which is otherwise called Brahma. So Brahma eva hoti ityarthaha. Then of course Vanamalakar also gives a lot of vyakhya on this. Then let us read. Drushtam cha phalam tasyochyate.
Drushtam cha phalam tasyochyate.
Annavan prabhutam annamasya vidyata iti annavan.
Annavan prabhutam annamasya vidyata iti annavan.
Satta matrena tu sarvo hi annavan iti.
Satta matrena tu sarvo hi annavan iti.
Vidyaya visheso nasyat.
Vidyaya visheso
nasyat. Okay. Drushtam cha phalam tasya uchyate. Tasya means for this seeker who is pursuing this Brahma Vidya. There is something which is Adrushtam Phalam. Adrushtam Phalam is he is in that level of Ananda. Only he knows it. Other people may not know it. Other people may be thinking that he is somebody like a madcap. Like you find a character like Jadabharata in Mahabhagavatam. Jadabharata is a jnani. And he is in that supreme level of Ananda. And then he is being kicked about by various people. Somebody goes and then he takes him as a sort of, say, palanquin carrier. Palanquin, you know, pallaki. Carrier. So this man is going like that. And then the king, the local king who is sitting there in that palanquin, he keeps on prodding him with his leg. So like that. But he was just oblivious of all those things. So Jadabharata was almost like somebody like a madcap. That's all. So, like that, other people may or may not know. Other people may sometimes know, may not know the greatness of that jnani. But then, drushtaphalam also is being told here. Drushtaphalam, drushtam cha phalam, tasya uchyate. For this brahmajnani, there is some drushtaphalam also. Why this drushtaphalam? As I said, when you go for shopping, there are some small gifts. So, it is like that. So, here... this Vanamalakara also writes, Vanamalakara and also Anandagiri, what does it say? Dushetacha dushtam phalam jivan mukta avaseshasya. Vanamalakara writes, Saguna vidya phalam भूम विद्या फलत्वेन संकीर्त्यते भूम विद्या स्तुत्यर्थम ही ड्रॉस अ पैरेलल विथ भूम विद्या इन छांदोग्य उपनिषद देर इज वन थिंग कॉल्ड भूम विद्या भूम इज अगेन ब्रह्मन ओनली भूम विद्या मीन्स ब्रह्म विद्या सो देर when that bhuma vidya in that brahma vidya when the, in that context also saguna vidya phalam also is told along with this bhuma vidya phalam though you are you no doubt you realize that brahma but you will also get this saguna vidya phalam saguna brahma vidya phalam that is you are worshipping a saguna brahma and that saguna brahma is the person who gives all the boons so all those things also will come to you all those things will also come to you as a result of this brahma vidya so this is something like an incentive we have seen in bhagavad gita also say swargam itself is something like a lollipop bhagavad gita does not say of course bhagavatam says swargam what we call swargam is something like a small say a gift a small lollipop given to a child but you have to move beyond that he says so that is told basically to praise this brahma vidya to lord this brahma vidya So that is the point. So we should why this is being said is that we should not think that this is something which is unconnected or unrelated. See, when we are talking about Brahma Vidya, talking about Annavan, Annado Bhavati, it looks rather petty, isn't it? So we should not think so. It is basically to praise that Brahma Vidya. The result of Saguna Vidya is also included along with that Brahma Vidya. So that is the point. अन्नवान प्रभूतम अन्नमस्य विद्यते इति अन्नवान प्लेंटी ऑफ फूड प्लेंटी ऑफ रिसोर्सेस लेट अस से अन्नम नॉट नेसेसरली फूड बट ऑल द लवली थिंग्स लेट अस से अन्नवान प्रभूतम अन्नमस्य विद्यते इति अन्नवान ही बिकम्स वन हैविंग ऑल दोस से थिंग्स देन सत्ता मात्रेण तु सर्वो ह्यन्नवान इति बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ Satta, by mere, if it is a mere presence of annam, Satta Matriyana, we are not talking about Brahma Satta or anything like that. Satta Matriyana means by mere presence of, Satta means presence, isn't it?
Yes.
By the mere existence of, by the mere presence of that annam, by the mere presence of those objects, everybody is arthavan only. Everybody is eating and everybody is having some possessions. Then vidyaya visheshonasyat, there will be no speciality of this vidya. So that is why, It is said, Annavan Prabhutam Anna. Prabhutam, the word Prabhutam. Annavan Prabhutam Anna Masya Vidyata. The word Prabhutam, though it is not there in the text, text only says Annavan Bhavati. Shankaracharya is using the word Prabhutam. He is justifying the use of the word Prabhutam because Annam is there with everybody. So this for this man who is pursuing this Brahma Vidya, he is getting Prabhutam Annam. Plenty, abundance, let us say. Prabhutam, plenty, abundance. So that is the reason he is just explaining why he has used that word called Prabhutam. Then evam annam atti iti evam annam atti tyannado
evam annam atti tyannado
deeptagnir bhavati ityarthah
deeptagnir bhavati ityarthah
annam atti ad dhatu you know ad means to eat atti iti annadah Annam atti iti annadaha. That is one who eats, one who enjoys. He is annadaha. He is the enjoyer. So evam, in this manner, annam atti, prabhutam annam atti. He enjoys all the things. He eats a lot. If you are confining only to food, he becomes, the jataragni or the fire in his stomach is so strong that he can gobble up anything. He can eat a lot. So if you generalize it, He is a person who has that capacity to enjoy. So and then, evam annam atti iti annadaha deepta agnir bhavati. Deepta agnihi. Deepta means something which is blazing. Deepta agnihi. One with a blazing fire in his stomach. Blazing fire, not only in the stomach, but in his the whole body. The whole body, that capacity is there to enjoy all things. So that is how we can take. एवं अन्नम अत्ति इति अन्नादः दीप्ताग्निर् भवति वन विथ सच ए से सच फायर इन हिज स्टमक ब्लेजिंग फायर लेट अस से देन महान भवति
केन
महत्वमित्यतः प्रजया पुत्रादिना पशुभिः गवाश्वादिभिः ब्रह्मवर्चसेन शमदम ज्ञानादि निमित्तेन तेजसा महान् भवति कीर्त्या ख्यात्या शुभप्रचार निमित्तया ओके देन महान् भवति ही बिकम्स ग्रेट सो दीस आर ऑल द लौकिक फलम यू सी अलोंग विद द अलौकिक फलम ही इज आल्सो मेंशनिंग द लौकिक फलम द श्रुति इज मेंशनिंग द लौकिक फलम हाउ इज इट महान् भवति केन महत्वम बाय व्हाट दैट ग्रेटनेस बाय व्हाट महान् भवति ही सेज ही बिकम्स ग्रेट ग्रेटनेस बाय व्हाट केन महत्वम इत्यतः प्रजया इन दोस डेज हैविंग लॉट मेनी चिल्ड्रन वाज आल्सो ग्रेट पुत्र संपत्ति प्रजा इज समथिंग नॉट ओनली दोस डेज बट ऑलवेज प्रजया पुत्र दिन सो ही हैज लॉट ऑफ सन्स रिलेटिव्स एंड ऑल दैट पुत्र आदि सो ही हैज गॉट ऑल दोस द एंटायर से एंटूराज ही हैज देन पशुभिः गव अश्वादिभिः गव इज कौ अश्व इज हार्स सो पशुभिः हैविंग लॉट मेनी लॉट ऑफ कैटल वेल्थ देन ब्रह्मवर्चसेन ही इज आल्सो हैविंग दिस ब्रह्मवर्चस आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन टू यू शम दम ज्ञानादि निमित्तेन तेजस दट सॉर्ट ऑफ ग्लो विच ही अटेन्स दट सॉर्ट ऑफ बॉडीली से डिमीनर विच ही गेट्स आफ्टर अटेनिंग दिस शम दम एंड ब्रह्मज्ञान द होल डिमीनर चेंजेस इज़न्ट इट So by that, then Mahan Bhavati Kirtya, and then he also becomes great by virtue of fame. Kirtya, Khyatya, Khyati means he is known to everybody. Khya Dhatu, Khya means Khyapanam, Khyapanam means to tell everyone. Prakhyati you say. Say Prakhyati is fame, he is known to everyone. So that sort of thing, Kirtya, Khyatya, Shubha Prachara Nimittaya, and positive news about him, not negative news. A fellow can become very famous or also notorious. There are two words. He doesn't become notorious. Notorious, you know, notorious is the opposite of famous. So he becomes famous for good deeds. He does not become notorious for bad deeds. So Shubha Prachara Nimittaya. So that is how we end this Shashtonavakaha. Maybe we'll take it up. We'll take the next thing in the next class. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांति